Today I want to talk about budget knives, budget folding knives, budget fixed blades by real steel. Of course there are a lot of brands which make budget knives like Kershaw, Buck, Spyderco, etc, etc. But a nice brand, I think they are active for about 2 years now, from China, is Real Steel. Instead of copying a copying knives from other brands, they make their own designs and they produce it with a very good fit and finish according the price range. They also have some higher end production knives. But today I want to show you the budget, some budget models from Real Steel. This is a brand I really, really like. They make good knives, usable, capable, great fitted finish, for very low prices, and they easily compare with their European made or US made knives, which are double the price. Okay, let's start with a very cheap one. This is a special one. This is a knife with a sterile blade. This is a knife produced by Sanrenmu for Real Steel. It is a liner lock. It has an 8CR14 MOV steel. It gets really, really sharp, shaving sharp, hair popping sharp. But the 8CR14 will lose its hair popping sharpness pretty fast. But you can maintain the edge really well by just dropping it and honing it on a ceramic stone or a leather strop. This is the model 9065, I think. Because it's a sterile blade, I think something went wrong with the production, because the same knife comes with the brand name Real Steel and all the prints with model number and steel. This one is about 10 euros cheaper than the printed model, which is the same knife, and this one can be bought for around 20 bucks, 20 euro, about $20 on the big Asian web stores like Fastech, DHgate, AliExpress. It's a very nice knife. The blade is about 9 centimeter or 3.5 inch long, overall about 8 inch. It's a very smooth knife, very easy one-handed deployment and one hand close. Very smooth knife, and this knife has already seen quite a lot of use. As you see, the set of finish even holds up very well. Very nice knife, very recommended for people with a tiny budget or with a big budget but who want to spend hundreds of dollars on a good knife. 20 euro, $20, and you get a very capable knife with a deep carry pocket clip with a good retention. Very nice knife. Next up, from Real Steel, and this one is from one of my daughters. This one I have seen a lot of use. This is the E79 model with G10 handle scale. It's a mid-size folding knife. This is probably one of the smoothest knives I have ever had in my hands. And I have really expensive knives from Benchmade, Chris Reeve, Spyderco. But this knife on Teflon washers, which have seen a lot of abuse from my daughter, carving wood, etc. No blade play, well centered. And this knife, I think it's about €25, $25, maybe a bit more, about 13. HCR 14 MOV, gets really sharp. It's about 7.5 centimeter or 3 inch blade. Very nice, very capable knife. This one is a flipper from Real Steel. It's not G10, kind of Zytel. This is the E77. This one is in the black wash version with olive drab handle scales. The same size as the E79, but another blade shape. Also very smooth, also on Teflon washers. Very nice knife. This one is from another daughter of me. Very smooth, well centered, no blade play. About the same price range, about €25, $25. Very nice knife. Fun to play with, liner lock, great fit and finish for the price, very smooth, very rounded edges, chamfered, very nice knife. Then a bit more expensive, you go to the 40-50 price range. This is a model that H6S1. This is a frame lock, steel frame with carbon fiber on the presentation side. Very clean look with a 14C28 Centvic steel. It's about 8 centimeter blade, 3.2 inch, 3.3 inch. Very nice stone wash over travel stop, which also functions as a lock for the frame lock, so it can't deploy of can't close on you when in use. It's lightweight, beautiful carbon fiber, great fit and finish, very nice flow through design with standoffs. Easy to clean, gets razor sharp. I never use the overtrav of the or the lock. It's a sturdy frame lock, so that will not close on you when in use. Very smooth knife, well centered, deploys easily one-handed and closes also very easy. Very nice knife. About €60, I think, $60. Next one, this is also an H6S1 model, the same as the carbon fiber one, but this one is with G10 scale on the presentation side, and this one is in camo. All these knives come in different color configurations, G10, carbon fiber, etc. etc. Great fit and finish, very smooth, very easy deployed and closed, very nice knives. This one is about €10 or $10 cheaper than the carbon fiber one. And this one, this is the H6 Blue Sheep. This is a bigger knife with about 9 centimeter blade or 3.5 inch. This one also comes in different configurations with coating, without coating, satin, stone washed, camo, urban camo, black, orange, all different kinds of colors. The frame lock, very nice knife, Very great, very good fit and finish, well centered, very smooth, very easy to open and close. This is my first real steel knife, and I fell in love with this brand because of this knife. Very beautiful. It also comes with some other grips, with more grooved grips, special editions. I think this model alone will have 20 different configurations available. This knife is about 50 euro or $50. I think in the US the prices are somewhat lower, but here over here in Holland around 50 euro, in Germany about 50 to 60 euro. Very nice capable knife, big knife. Then the Thor. This is a newer model of real steel. This is the T101 Thor. It's a flipper, about the same size as the H6. A little bit smaller, maybe a half a centimeter. Very smooth knife on ball bearings. This one is so smooth, it's about 60 euro, and it easily can compete knives from 120, 140 euro over here in Europe. Very, very nice capable knife. And the Takin, also a newer model for 2015. This is a very big knife, about 11 and a half centimeter or 4.1 inch. Liner lock, G10 handle scales, but very nice polished. The pivot is hidden under the scales. In fact, you could call this a frame lock, but okay, because of the scales I will call it a liner lock. Also in the 14C28 steel, very nice capable knife, about 60 euro. This one comes with a pouch, a very sturdy pouch, which can be attached to your belt. There's a nice extra option for carrying it besides the clip for in your pants. I never used a pouch. Then Real Steel has some fixed blades. I have several, but I just want to show you one model because it's a smaller one. It's a very capable knife. It's comparable with the E79 in size. It's a 2.5 inch blade, about 7 centimeters with G10. This blade is very nice stone washed, very nice fit and finish, and it's made in the same steel as a lot of Mora knives, the 12C27 steel from Sandvik. So it takes a real nice edge. It maintains that its edge pretty good. It comes with a nice sheet. And this could be carried like a neck knife because of its weight and is pretty small. But it also has an extra attachment for clipping it on your belt. This can be attached several ways for horizontal and vertical carry. Very nice knife, and it's about 35 euro, I think. $35. Probably in the US they will be cheaper. Most real steel knives I've seen were much cheaper. For example, I saw an offer for the Takin, which will cost about 60 euro in Holland, and I saw that for below $40 in the US. So that's a huge price difference. But this is the real steel Hunter 165. Very nice knife, very easy to carry. It's a nice knife for camp work, when camping, when out in the woods. You can do some wood tasks with it, carving tasks. It can even beton thin wood. You can use it for food prep, etc. Very nice knife. For its size, it has a good grip. Very nice, useful jimping, not overly aggressive. You can choke up. I think you can even use it, hence the name, for skinning rabbit, squirrel, etc. Very, very nice knife. Very capable. Nice attachment for a lanyard. Great fit of finish for such a cheap knife. Okay. Real steel. In the meantime, it gets well known in Germany. In Holland, it's not that much known, but it starts. But in the United States, I think it's not very common. These are some of the budget models I have. There are some more expensive models, like the Megalodon, Kit Carson design, very nice knives with S35 VN steel. But today I want to limit it to these budget models. All these knives I can recommend, all of them, without exception. All come with great fit of finish, all come razor sharp from the factory. The only exception, which came not sharp, was this H9 Takin. This was the first real steel knife I got that was not sharp, at least not to my standards. And I had several hours work to get the edge on the level I wanted it, namely poppin' sharp, poppin' hair sharp. But now I'm very satisfied with this knife. Okay, if you have comments, I will read them, I will answer them. Bye bye.